Hey guys, welcome to the Linux channel. In this episode, I'm just going to do a teardown of this, D-Link 8-port 1Gbps Ethernet switch, guys. This model is DGS1008A, and this I just purchased quite recently, and this I just purchased as a part of my TrafficSqueezer test network, in which a customer needs to test in terms of performance of TrafficSqueezer in a 1 Gbps test simulated WAN links, and as well as in terms of conversion of 1 Gbps to 100 Mbps test speeds, as so that you have a 1 Gbps LAN and then 100 Mbps WAN, things like that as such. So I am just using this for a while, and I thought let me just do a teardown video and discover what is the sort of hardware it contains inside, and especially its switching core and things like that as such. So here are some of the tool, guys, which I just grabbed for this job. I just got a flathead screwdriver, as you can see. And I just don't know where I kept my prying tool as such. So I'm just using this flathead screwdriver for that, and just in case I'm just using this very cheap, I think it is I got it in Dollar Tree or somewhere actually, so a cheap knife, something like this. And I just don't want it to be very sharp, so that is why I'm using this knife. I have another expensive knife, but I fear when you do pry open your case, it may damage the case actually. So, and I have this multi-bit screwdriver set, as you can see, just in case. And apart from that, a tweezer in case if some screw or something falls down as such. So, and apart from that, I have just in case another set of screwdriver set, as you can see. Here is the D-Link switch, guys, and let me just push these tools aside. You can see it much closer here, and I hope the camera is focusing its model name as such. So let me just show its front. Its model is printed over here, which is DGS1008A actually. So unfortunately, this doesn't have any screws. I just checked before shooting this video. That is the reason I just grabbed my prying tools as such. So I need to figure out how I can just separate this case, the bottom part with the top part actually. So I can find a small gap over here, just in case if I pull, as you can see, it is just little bit, I'm just able to do that. So I think I can just start pry open from this end as such, so for that I can just use this flathead screwdriver. I am not much bothered in terms of damaging the case to an extent, but at the same time I don't want to damage the board, since I just need to use this device for some more time as such. So with this screwdriver, I can just get some point where I can start with. I just a little bit managed to lift this open, and as you can see here, there is a small gap. I think this is the place it is connected to the bottom part actually. So I'm just leveraging this part, and using the knife, I'm just going to rip it apart. It's not that hard, but still I just need to be very careful so that it doesn't break this plastic cover as such. I'm almost halfway across, and I can see almost three sections here. I just thought this is going to be intact with this, with a screw or something like that actually, but it turns out the board is just held in place with the plastic notches over here as such. So I don't think so there are any screws inside. So there you have it, guys. Finally, it has been pried open. It's kind of a bit hard in the other sides, and I just managed so that I don't damage the board in any way as it. So hope you can see, the board is not damaged in the process. There are no knife marks, and at the same time, even the case is looking good as you can see. I think I can put back and I can start using this asset. So now let's just take this board apart. I think it is held in place with some sort of it's been almost used for a few months, so you can see little amount of dust which is collected in the underside of the board. Actually, I hope you can see if I wipe with my finger, it appears much whiter in color. So these are the status LEDs you can see, and it contains this switch, the main switch core processor. Let's just grab on magnifying glass and let's just read its specifications. I just grabbed this magnifying glass, and I just got this small pen torch which I just use for things like this assets. It's just not this hardware. Generally, whenever I buy any kind of expensive hardware, sometimes I just do a teardown. It's just that almost this is my first teardown video, guys. I just thought let me share my enthusiasm with you guys, in case you may find it extremely useful in terms of understanding various networking equipment and things like that, actually. So let's just see what is the processor it is, what is the processor model it is. So I can read the processor model, guys, which is RTL837ON, and below that it is printed as DBF00E2 as such. It's a Taiwanese chip, guys. Let me just try to focus this processor to the camera. I hope I can just focus it manually or with the aid of this magnifying glass. It's very nice, guys. I mean, I have done a teardown of my old 100 Mbps Ethernet switches earlier, which is around 6 to 8 years old or things like that. I have done some teardown of couple of my D-Link switches earlier, but I never seen a switch which is so simple in terms of its hardware layout. As you can see, it doesn't really have any sort of extra components as such. So probably I may take another video of my 100 Mbps Ethernet switch, and in case if you compare, it contains a lot more components as such. So although it is looking so simple, it is so astonishing that it is a 1 Gbps Ethernet switch, guys. And these status LEDs will glow in amber in case if you connect it to a 100 Mbps link, and in case if you connect it to a 1 Gbps link, it will glow in green color, guys. So there you have, guys, the teardown of D-Link DGS 1000A model Ethernet switch. I hope you liked watching this video. Please do subscribe to this channel, guys, and please do share it with your friends and colleagues. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you. Have a nice day.